Hi guys, this is Pettyflex Reactions. So I'm going to continue from where I'm left off. I'm on season 3, episode 7. This one's called Worse Things Than Betrayal. I think they're going to find out a bit more about the Priory, which is good because I want to know.
Can it ever be fixed?
Maybe. But it will take a very long time and there are things to do. Follow me.
What could be more important than that?
Oh, Cal's such a dud now. Install lights. Cute.
Magic lanterns.
Lightning. Not magic.
You put lightning into lamps and you tell us it's not magic?
It's really not. Parthians were storing lightning in jars 200 years before Christ.
You had many human warrior slaves. Maybe more than we can take on our own.
Well, we can look at tactics.
And the lightning lamps? Can lightning be a weapon too? Could you make lightning kill a lot of people at once?
Let's start small, shall we?
Of course. We are just worried about a lot of things. You're being incredibly kind, and we are very grateful.
I know you're worried. Tucker, you need to understand that I'm not just passing on ways to murder people. All right, but you don't need to understand. I'm sharing all of this with you. So that you remember it and pass it on. I think Trevor Belmont would like the idea of equipping a new generation of monster hunters.
Oh, he's thinking about Trevor.
No running. I've told you 1,000 times I want no children running like wild dogs through my town. And you're here first thing in the morning because you like the freshest apples, aren't you? I thought so. Would you like to know a secret? If you go into the woods through the back field and follow the path into the fork, you go down the way with the big tree that you all say looks like an angry face, and you go over the creek, past the point the way your parents say you shouldn't go, right? I happen to know there's an apple tree in the clearing after that. It's mine. Apple tree, and nobody's allowed to go there. So, if you promise not to tell a soul where you're going, go get yourself 3 apples, and no more running.
That's either really nice or super dodgy.
Rather early.
Lots to do, probably not enough time to do it.
I'm told you were drinking with Bernardis and Belmont yesterday.
I'm extremely famous, and they wanted to meet someone who'd seen toilet. Morning, Judge.
Toilet paper.
What do they use? Shit in the corner. Still, oh yeah, still there. Looks like it's made of skin. Book of Monsters. Page is missing.
This book, do you recognize it?
I don't.
Someone recently read this book, Sala, after which they tore a section out because the missing section involves methods and processes for returning people from hell.
I've so simply pulled out those pages to wipe that backside web. I understand they use paper for that.
It was written by a forge master some 200 years ago, an insane forge master who did not practice in the usual way.
Ooh, a dangerous, crazy forge master. Interesting. He made himself a unicorn. Delightful. and got it to be purple as well.
Good morning, Sir Forge Master.
Doesn't seem freaked out.
I smell you. Once upon a time, you may have found it quite overfull.
Do you do this?
Oh, no. Oh, God, no. There's a town 30 miles up the road. Rather prison, really.
Yes.
Since that is the direction I'm headed, perhaps you'd give a traveler and fellow practitioner a friendly warning.
You can smell me too?
I see you.
So she's a forge master too.
The town is run by a magician. He has dreams of a city, a slave population to build it. So he swept up the surrounding villages, cooked their souls down to ash, turned them into ants.
So, you let this magician take your neighbors. I wonder why.
Oh, hail!
This life takes a toll, Forge Master.
It does.
But the magic is thin now. I couldn't do a thing for anyone else. I had to just watch.
The magician never came back for you.
The mad bastard building a city-state here. One day the Styrians will punch through the cities that enclose them and swarm across the country.
I was betrayed. I could not do a thing.
To obtain such a treasure, you will have to kill everyone in that town so that the magician has no defense. Entire population into more of your night creatures, equipping you with a full army. Yes, I probably should have mentioned that I am quite mad. Oh, kill them all, pretty Forge Master. They'll thank you for it. There are worse things than betrayal.
A lot of Forge Master thingy going on in this episode. Like that book in the Priory. Carving stuff again.
Let me take care of it.
I've been
useless ever since all of this became about magic and weird symbology.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
That's not questioning, that's fighting. Oh my god. Ooh. There goes the gib. No, no, my God, no. Oh. Oh God, no. Nah. There's something wrong with him, isn't there?
I found your vandal. He's a very naughty monk. Tell the judge what the symbol means.
Fuck you to death.
Charlie, these people are intending to take some kind of action against the town.
Book's troubling him. Oh no. Oh. I do think it's... Oh. Oh. Oh, hell no. So there's a crucified freaking demon in the keep, or whatever it's called. Just when you think this can't get more disturbing. Why would that demon want that? If that was that demon's plan, why would it want that? You know? Like, oi vicar, could you crucify me please? It's all part of my big master plan. I don't get it. Anyway, thanks for watching guys. Stay tuned for episode 8 of season 3. Leave comments, I love to read them. Thanks for watching. Bye.